I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out. Enough what Odin did to me. He's desecrated every memory I have of home.
Be glad you have a home to remember fondly. In Sparta, we were taken from our homes as children and raised in the Ogoyi. We marched though we drowned, fought for scraps or starved. Our elders beat us till we could not stand. At night, we made our way home, alone, or were food for wolves. That is how Spartans are made.
These plants behave similarly to the scornholes we found in the foothills of Midgard ages ago. Well, considering how Spartans are made, it's no wonder you turned out as you did. Your fate was sealed from the start.
Fate can be overcome.
I used to think so. When the Norns told me of my son's fate, I thought I could change it. You know well how that worked out.
The Norns, the fates of these lands.
That's right. You defy prophecy at your own peril.
Atreus would agree with you about prophecy. He rushes blindly to a fate the giants foretold. Disappears for 2 days, trying to prove he is their champion, fabled to fight at Ragnarok.
What? I know all the Ragnarok prophecies. There's no champion at the giants.
It is one Groa concealed. Because of this champion, the realms are saved at Ragnarok. Only Asgard falls, and Odin with it.
So all this time, Odin's obsession with every detail of Ragnarok has been missing a crucial piece. Ha! Well done, Bro.
Atreus will not be a pawn of prophecy.
You still stand against fate, even with victory foretold.
I will not march my son to war. He is no Spartan. I would keep it that way.
You would speak to me of protecting your child? Is my tragedy not enough of a lesson? Fighting fate is a waste of the precious time we're going to spend with them. You never know when someone will come along and cut it short. Your blades to throw a torch to the other side. Let's cross the bridge now. Anyone alive be squeamish about war? After all the gods you've killed.
I have seen enough war to know the cost.
And I don't. After the price I paid to end one? Look around you, Kratos. See what happens when you don't fight a true evil. That's one of Odin's captains. Be ready.
Ascolta la scala.
From you today. Can you please just shut up and kill things? Not it.
not tell me to kill again.
What?
I killed to protect my son, to aid my friends. But I will be no one's monster. Never again.
You don't get to make that choice. Not with the debt you owe me.
I am not here for debts. I would always have helped you.
So much has been taken from me, and I'm just supposed to let it all go?
Freya.
Enough. There. I feel the source of the magic keeping me in Midgard.
What is this place?
My home. I was born here. Hold on. Something's not right. Opinbera. World tree roots. Bound in Odin's damn knots. That's how he did it. Come on! Niflheim!
Creature! It belongs to Odin?
No. It protects Yggdrasil's roots, wherever they are. Bastard was counting on it.
Guard them with her life. Weapon! Let us finish this!
It's opening its stomach again! Get ready! Evade! You can't block a blast that powerful! I've shot a sigil into its stomach! You know what to do! Clear the area!
Done.
It's over. It's really over.
And now that you have what you seek,
I suppose this is the point where I forgive you, where I kill you.
Have you decided?
To be honest, I don't think I can do either. There's still a part of me that is so angry, and it'll always be. It'll always be angry. But no. You are not the one who needs to die. I do see that. Everything that's happened between us.
No need to explain. Not to me. Not for that. I do not regret saving your life. And never will. But the choice between life and death should have been yours to make. I should not have robbed you of that choice.